Hello people of YouTube, my name is Brad, this is my channel, and I'm an orange, and welcome to part two, the well overdue part two of the Peacock builds. I'd like to apologize to everyone who has been waiting for well over a year for this. Life has changed. But anyway, I'm not going to talk about that now. Let's get to it. Let's finish up this model build. It took me a bit to figure out how to layer these feathers, then I realized I had mixed up my pieces. Not quite sure if the part was labeled wrong on the sheet or if I just goofed up. Good thing the individual parts have numbers stamped into them, and that helped me get it straightened out. Once I finally had the correct parts in hand, it was fairly easy to understand how these parts go. The feathers pretty much stack on each other. The pattern is the same on each new feather. Bend one tab down and the other tab up, then set the new feather on top of the other ones on the end. Of course, bend the tabs over to secure them. Next, we have completed the cluster of feathers. It is time to attach them to the larger bracket. Thank you. As you can see, this is fairly simple. Bend the tabs at 90 degrees, aligning the tabs with the slots to fit the part, then bend the tabs over to secure. I used either my fingernails or the tweezers to bend and secure the tabs. Now to give the wing a little shape. There we go. Now onto the other wing. Since you have seen me build one and the other is constructed in the same manner but mirrored, I'm going to skip some of the detail and speed through this part a bit. Thank you. another wing is done. Now to attach the stand. Now that we have the wings built and the stand connected, it's time to add the wings on. This is where having some sculpting tools comes in handy. I had to reach inside the cavity to bend over the tabs. I needed tools that would accomplish that task. I know you can't see what I'm doing inside the Peacock. I have somewhat recently acquired an endoscope, and I thought I could at least give you a peek inside of what I had done and sort of an example of how I did it. Sorry for the shaky hands. I need to work on my filming technique with the scope. Now onto the rather large tail feathers. They layer on top of each other a bit like the wing feathers. I forgot to bend the tabs on the other part. Thank you.
this tail assembly is getting a bit too big to hold. Now that the tail feathers are connected, it is time to curve and attach the tail. We got the two tabs at the base of the neck. And the two tabs on each side of the body. And then we have two more tabs on each side to hold down the wings.
Thank you.
And that's it. Oh wait, we need to add the pad on the bottom of the bass.
And that brings us to the end of part two and the end of this Peacock build that we have here. Basically, in summary, it was a fun build. There were some challenges. Some of the difficult things I remember is getting the head together, getting like the head and neck pieces to fit, getting the feet to work quite right was a bit of a challenge. But once we moved on to the feathers, it was pretty simple layering everything. And then the final fight to get it all together. And then the stand. The stand is not the greatest. When I first finished building it, I was able to, with manipulating the tail feathers a little bit, stand it on its own. And then, like, the next day or that evening, something happened and it toppled over. And I've not been able to get it to stand since. So what I did, I don't know if you can hear it rattling around, I put a little piece of metal or magnet in there. And I have a heavier magnet that I can use to keep it from falling over when it's put on display. Because this is all the I guess brass, the softer metal, it's not magnetic like a lot of the things you see behind me, like most Metal Earth models. None of this is actually magnetic, so I had to kind of fudge a little bit to get that to work, but it works. I had it sitting over there for most of the past year that you've been waiting on this video, and I apologize for that. I have made comments here and there through social media about what's going on with life, and yeah, this got put behind. I honestly at one point thought that I'd finished this video, and someone asked when it was coming out, and I went back and realized no, I was down to like the last couple of steps and got pulled away. But anyhow, here is the final video. And I think I still have one more to finish up, because I don't know that I ever finished the review for the space shuttle, and I have the review for this. Now, unfortunately, I'm not able to show the model in its usual 360 rotation. It keeps falling over. I still have the original little small Metal Earth display that I have had for years, but I had replaced it with a sort of a battery operated display one that you can get on Amazon with a glass top. It's larger and I can control the speed a little bit, and I've used it for a few videos, but it does have a slight catch in it sometimes, and every time I did that the model just fell over. And it's to the point where you'll notice in the picture the feather piece on the top has disappeared. It fell off twice. I put it back on once. Now I can't figure out where it is, so my apologies. Here you go. As always, thank you for watching. If you have any questions about this build, feel free to ask down below, and I will do my best to answer your questions. And keep on keeping on.